Hey everybody, welcome to another Out of the Basement. This is on indie and smaller, lesser played miniature games. And this week we are doing Dark Age from Cool Mini or Not. Now you guys may or may not have heard of Dark Age. They were originally released in 2002 and it was a post-apocalyptic planet where all the artwork was being done by Brom. It was all very dark and grim. It was a skirmish style game with small squads, heroes, and there was really no good guys. There was evil monster natives. There was crazy human cultists that had basically risen from the ashes of their abandoned planet. And then there was some toxic sort of like creations dumped into like a genetic vat that came out all weird and gross, and cannibalistic mutant raiders. So it was kind of a game of no good guys, and it kind of was off and on, sort of like petering around for a few years, until it was recently picked up by Cool Mini or Not. Now Cool Mini or Not has been doing a whole bunch. They've been re-sculpting the line, kind of modernizing the miniatures, because they're like 10 or 13 years old.
Very good sculpts.
Very, very cool sculpts. And trying to sort of like revitalize the game. And so what they've done is they've actually started doing a bunch of new things compared to what Dark Age did previously in its previous incarnations before they acquired it. They give away all the rules for free online. So all the stat cards, all of the rule books, their tournament session, which is sort of like their steamroller if you're playing War Machine, or their gaining grounds if you're playing Malifaux. All available for free, all can be printed online. And then the miniatures themselves, you don't need as many as you used to play. And the unit selection is a lot more fluid. So that's another thing they've changed. If you did play Dark Age maybe 10 years ago, you're not buying groups of models anymore. You can buy any models you want, put them in an army. There are certain restrictions on how many you can have based on how big the game size you're playing is. And if they are of the same type, they get an ability called Squad Link, where they can activate together and deploy together, but they don't have to. So it's got kind of taken a page now from games like Malifaux, where you build the collection of miniatures you like, and you build a list with what you want to use. So I'm here with Jordan today.
Hey.
And he's a Legionnaire for Cool Mini or Not, and we are going to try playing Dark Age. Now, we are using the Dark Age miniatures that I've had sitting in a bin forever, because I haven't actually been playing Dark Age since probably 2002, to try out the new rules. I'm playing a St. John Warband, which is the Forsaken. He's kind of the only good guy, so if the background for the Forsaken are, they're the human colonists that were on this planet. This planet was in the middle of nowhere and not really very useful for like the human Galactic Dominion or whatever it was. Nobody even remembers what it was called anymore.
Unless you're a criminal.
Unless you're a criminal. So it gets surveyed and then deemed like not really fit for human habitation because it's so far from all the trade lanes and it's not really useful. But then it gets marked on a little ledger for the corporations as like, oh, so no one's going to go there. And they start sending their like illegal experimentation and like all of their like bad weapons research. And like every dirty deed you could possibly do as a corporation ends up on this planet.
Questionable people.
Questionable people, that's right. It's not really Mos Eisley, it's not pirates. It's like evil corporations that built like research centers and stuff there. And this is several hundred years in the past now. And then what happens is one day it becomes no longer viable for them to be there. So they pull up stakes and they just abandon all the workers and like their families and everything on the planet. So for a couple hundred years, people run riot, starvation, death, the whole world's just falling apart, infrastructure goes away. The natives reemerge, which is the Jagiri, and then just bad things happen. So like the unattended genetic experiments get loose, people turn into evil cannibal raiders, and that's kind of the state of the planet when you get there. Then the humans who end up taking control and rebuilding civilization are using the foundations of found old religious texts to create like a society that controls the population, and they become the saints. And the saints each lead different warbands, they're kind of range from good to bad. The original saint, Saint Mark, his whole thing is he finds this book and he's like, I could totally get people to do whatever I want if I say I'm super. So he does, and he's the one that doesn't really buy it what he's selling. He's kind of a snake oil salesman. Then there's Saint John, who's actually just a good dude and is trying to like protect the humanity. He's the one I'm playing. And he's just trying to protect the population, basically, and he's actually, you know, taking care of his troops and actually employing medics and stuff like that, whereas St. Mark is just, like, filling them full of combat drugs and Novocaine to go fight monsters.
You can do it.
Yeah, and then there's St. Mary, who's kind of a Joan of Arc character, and then there's also some other crazy saints who've gone nuts. St. Luke, who becomes one of the cannibal raider guys and goes all native and cuts his arms off and stitches on things. Arms and stuff. It's bad. Anyway, it's pretty dark. So I'll be playing them, St. John, Forsaken Warbands, and then Jordan Cameron. I call him by his last name all the time. Jordan. He's going to be playing, you guys don't know him like I know him. Jordan's going to be playing Dragiri, the Ice Cast, which is sort of the natives. Each of them is based on an element. The Ice Cast, their wizards will use things like Arctic Walls, you know, like frozen blasts, sort of like weird sort of arctic themed spells and stuff, like bolts of ice, exactly, clouds. Spikes of ice, clouds. And then they have slaves, which are like the lesser versions of them. It's kind of like orcs and squigs.
Yeah.
From what I can tell, they have a sort of like symbiotic relationship, but they do get squashed a lot. So he's got a lot more guys than I do, but the guys he has aren't very good. His big dudes are awesome, and his little dudes are just kind of there to stand in the way and keep me from doing stuff. So we're going to play a mission from the 2015 tournament pack. Now, some cool things about the game itself. It's D20 based, it's card based, so you'll get to see Jordan actually print off all his cards. I'm gonna just put them in card sleeves, which you guys can do at home. I have a set of the Forsaken cards. The Forsaken cards are getting redone in the next little while too, so I think my stat lines might change a little bit, my point cost might change a little bit, but I'm using the current ones as of the filming of this, which is mid-July. And then all the templates and stuff we've cut out as well. So you could just do this at home if you have the miniatures and just get right to playing. We've printed off a copy of the rulebook. And the basic selection is you have a main objective each round when you play the tournament system, the objective sort of scenario system. And then you have a deck of secondary objectives. And you either print those off if you want, but you shuffle them. And every time you start a game, you deal two to yourself. You're allowed to discard at the start of your turn if you want. And if you complete one, you discard it as well. And then you deal new ones. And over the course of a tournament, you're trying to accumulate as many victory points as possible by getting your primaries at the end of the game and, of course, completing your secondaries as well. So we're going to show you the table setup, our armies, we'll get through the mission, and then get started. And for the first couple turns, we'll go through the basic mechanics of the game. So here is my St. John warband, led by John himself. So this is St. John right here in his little power armor with his thunder hammer and storm shield. And he's wearing like some relic-y armor, and he's got a relic hammer. Now his shield actually is also an energy weapon. It's a little gun. It shoots at the bottom of the shield there. Which does give him a ranged option as well. Now, in this game, there's army lists for each faction, and what usually happens is you pick a theme for your faction. So John's warband has access to troop types, and there's generic troop types and specialty ones. These guys are all generic troops here, so my two Banes, my Ravage, my Field Medic, my Weaponsmith, they can be taken by any Forsaken warband. These guys are basic hitters, they're just like line troops, she'll keep people alive. The Ravage is like a Grenadier and kind of an elite troop, and the Weaponsmith's there to keep guys' weapons from malfunctioning. He allows you to ignore malfunctioning weapons, because obviously the weapons being used in this planet are like 200 years old and don't work so good anymore. And then these guys are Haniels. They're part of the St. John list only. So these sort of like regular looking Bedouin kind of dressed guys with their rifles are only available to John. And it gives me some ranged options. They can use their guns like blunderbusses to fire flechettes, or they can fire like solid slugs as well. So that's my 500 points. Now what's cool is I have a whole bunch of sidebar models too, so in other games I might pick other ones. I have another Ravage I could use. He's pretty expensive though. I had a couple Firestorms, which is John's ladies in bikinis with flamethrowers, and some Coils, and the Coils are... they shoot these weird like little saw blade disc launchers, and they've got some melee abilities too. So they're kind of like an in-between ranged or combat model, as opposed to the Banes being just a combat model. A little bit more expensive though, so I couldn't fit them in the list. So that's my 500 points. That's my model pool over there on the side. And that's what I'll be taking for our first game. So here we have the Icecast Dragiri. These are the natives on the planet who kind of re-emerged to try and take their planet back from humanity. We've got in the middle here a Soul Warden. So he's like the evil alien wizard. And you might notice he's huge. These guys are on 50 mil bases. So the big guy, little guy dynamic is pretty prevalent in this one. We have two Soul Searchers. Their whole thing is they're the hitters. They're like the sort of legionaries in this list. And their job is basically just to fight in melee and not much else. And then over here we have a Soul Splitter. He's a bolt thrower. He has a psychogenic. Now, this guy's a wizard, right? So he's got access to all the ice psychogenics. He can use two per turn. This fella right here, he's got a built-in one. He can just use that one. It's basically a fog cloud that protects him from being hit. These guys up here, though, they infiltrate. They do have one ability, which allows them to be up table at the start of the game. And we have a horde of spearmen. These are slave spearmen. Their job is literally just to get underfoot and stab things with spears. And then there's a taskmaster. The taskmaster's job is to keep them from running away, because as guys die, they take panic counters, and panic is bad. He can whip them to be back in shape. And then these guys are some shard spreaders. The shards are basically these chunks of like explosive mineral that these guys use as weapons. They can throw them down as little minefields or use them like grenades. So there it is. That's 500 points of Icecast Dragiri. It's worth mentioning that just like the Forsaken, there's other casts that these guys can come from. There's the fire cast, and the wind cast, or the air cast as well. And those two casts are, just sort of themed differently. This is all general stuff. So these guys right here can be taken by anyone, as well as the Soul Warden and these splitters. I believe actually they're all general.
Yeah,
it's entire. So literally, you could add guys from any other cast this army, and change it up. This is just a completely general made Dragieri list. I got that backwards. These three guys are ice cast only. So yeah, so these guys are the theme ones that are from the ice cast list, and then this stuff, the warden, and all of these guys are general. So here's our table set up for the slaughtering fields. We put down some appropriately post-apocalyptic looking sort of like tech ruins for us to be playing in here in the wastes. Now every single game also has to have objectives because your primary or your secondary objectives when you flip them often have to have you interact with these 50 mil objectives. So we just place down six. In this one you have to place six within 8 inches of the, sorry, within 4 inches of the center line and not within 4 inches of each other. And we went back and forth deploying them. And then we have our stack, our decks here of secondary objectives, and we will deal ourselves two at the start of every single round. So we're going to get to deployment now by dicing off. And you win. Low rolls are good in this game. So a 1 is a critical success, a 20 is a critical failure. We'll get to more of that later. But Jordan's 1, so he can pick sides, and we'll get to deployment. We alternate deployments, and deployment's a 12-inch from our table edge in slaughtering fields. And what happens is all models with the same name type have to go down at the same time. They have to go together necessarily. There's benefits to doing so, but that means I'll be able to deploy my Banes, my Ravage, my Weaponsmith, my Field Medic, my two Haniels, and my St. John as individual drops. That means I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 drops. It also means Jordan's Slave Spears all have to go down. Yeah, Shards all have to go 12. Down. That's one right. Time. And at the end, his two Soul Searchers, because they infiltrate, will go last. So here we are deployed. I've got my Haniel, my two Banes, broken up with my St. John. Now the Field Medic has a bubble of 8 inches around her, where instead of being removed when guys die, they get a dying counter, and they stay on the table until she walks over and tries to patch him up. My Weaponsmith's up here on a hill, because he's not very good at anything but shooting, so hopefully he can just cover those two objectives. I got my Ravage to go toss some grenades and stuff, and my other Haniel out here on a flank. He didn't take the bait, though, but maybe he should be able to go get one of those objectives.
Yeah, I see you guys to deploy.
Oh, that's right, you got your infiltrators. So now we've got the huge blob of spears over there, with the Taskmaster in behind, the Soul Splitter up top on the hill, the Warden in behind, and then the Spreaders in the center. And now your infiltrators get to go down, which is your two Soul Searchers. And what's the range for their deployment?
They're said to be 12 inches away from you, so basically the center line.
Okay.
So you have shooting, which I don't like.
Sure do! I'm gonna hide behind some walls.
Yeah, I'm gonna make them nice and close
sense.
Together.
All right, that sounds like a good idea. So now we are deployed, so now we go to the first round of the game. Before we do it, we draw two secondary objective cards. And we have to look at them. These are things we're trying to do. So now I don't tell him, but I can show you guys. That's cool. And then this guy right here. Probably not gonna get that one early. So here's the basics of the game round. There's a preparation round where like lingering effects and stuff take place, and there's initiative. So once again, low rolls are good. We both roll off to see who activates first, and then we go to the activation phase. The activation phase, you pass from player to player activating a model, and if you have no models, the guy just completes the rest of his models. So it does have a simultaneous game turn, which I kind of like. It's a bit like Malifaux in that way, in that you pick a guy, I pick a guy, and they get to go. Now there's a rule called squad link though. So for instance, my two Banes here have squad link. If they're within a certain range of each other, up to the squad link number on their card get to activate at the same time, which is kind of cool. It means that lower point models usually get to blitz a little bit, and they have a squad link of 6. So you can see down here on their card, there's a link symbol, and then Bane 6. So up to 6 of them can activate as a single activation, and they just all resolve their activations before you pass play back over to the other player. Right, so we're gonna make a roll now to see who gets the initiative for the first turn.
Wait. I gotta do the slaves first.
Oh, that's right. Sorry, we just talked about this too. So before the initiative roll happens, his slaves are disorganized, and that means that they always activate basically at the end of the preparation phase before initiative. And there's no need to squad link them because they just all go right now. Now they're not very good. How many AP do they have?
They actually have a couple AP. They've got 2.
2. Okay. So most models have 3. They can take 3 actions per turn. You can use an action just like in something like Malifaux to move, to interact with something, to make an attack, to get up and get down from being prone. There's a whole list of basic abilities for this game that you like to do, and these guys only have 2. So they get to make a move. I imagine you're going to be doing with each one of them?
Yeah, pretty much.
What's their movement value?
Wow, spear slaves are 5.
Holy moly, that's pretty fast, actually.
They're 5.
That makes sense, though, because the lower the AP, the higher you'd want that move value to be, so they can actually get around.
So I'm just going to do both my AP to do moves to just get up.
And sort of jam up the zones. Faster.
So every model actually activates individually because they aren't squad linked.
Mm-hmm. But because they're all going before the initiative phase, it's pretty much irrelevant.
Yeah, so they all just get to move anyways. Okay. And then, sadly, the spear or the slave taskmaster moves a lot slower. He only actually moves 3, I believe.
Does he have more AP though?
He does. He's got an extra one, so
that's probably for his whipping ability, so he can remove the counters, panic damage from guys. So his role is basically to keep the guys from running away. they're all moved up there, and now here come the shards guys.
They're just gonna get out.
So what's interesting about this is it actually means Jordan's only got 4 activations during the turn. Even though he's got so many more guys than me, he's probably be out activated well before I am.
Every round.
Now we roll initiative. Yeah. Back on track here, Ash. 12 to 5, so you rolled lower than me, which means you win, and you get to pick the model to activate first. Or in this game, and I kind of like this, he can make me pick a model to activate first.
So I'm actually going to make you activate him first, because he's got the grenade launcher.
The Ravage, probably a good idea.
I want him to go before I get close
to him. Alright, so we're going to show how he works. He's one of my elite troops, he's a grenadier. Got a little cog symbol there at the top, that's how many actions I get. Defense, which we'll get to when we start making attacks, is here. Actually, the lower your defense number, the better. The higher your defense number is in this game, it makes it easier for you to hit. Your armor, again, high is good. Your move, the little foot symbol there. Your psych, which is like your leadership, your courage, and then how many hit points you have at the bottom. So my Ravage can take 2 before he dies. Now they do have squad link, but I only have 1. And he has 3 AP and a movement of 3. So I'm just gonna get him up the table here a little bit. I don't really wanna get too close though, because I don't wanna get too far away from my medic, because I don't wanna die. So we're just gonna move up, and then move laterally slightly, like so. And then with my last AP, I think I'll move just laterally again, like that. All right, so play passes to you.
All right, so I'm gonna get my Soul Warden up. He's got 4 AP, but he's only got a movement of 2. These guys are slow.
Yeah, so he's only running 8, basically, if he does all of his AP to move. But he's got other abilities. He's got Psychogenics from the ice deck, which means he can cast crazy ice spells.
So I'm actually gonna move him up 6 there, and I'm gonna check, make sure.
Because you can pre-measure in this game.
He's actually going to keep going. Today, okay. He's just going to run.
He's
just going
to trundle?
Yep,
trundle. All right, with an only 8-inch gun, my Haniel is just going to start walking. Now, they've got 3 AP as well, and a movement of obscured on my card. Okay, so there we go. It's a little bit better now. I had them flipped over, so the little silvery thing was literally over like the relevant stats. So pro tip, don't do that. Say I movement 3, which means I can move 3 inches per AP. I don't want to get too close though, because I know he's got a movement of good and at least 3 actions, and he can murder me. So we're going to start moving forward. We're probably going to go this way. So 3, 3, and then not quite 3. We're just going to kind of hang.
Oh, come on, come on.
She's not within 4 of her other friendly Haniel, so there's no squad link ability available.
So now I'll activate my Soul Splitter, who's got 3 AP.
And a 20-inch gun.
Yeah, 20-inch gun. So, do I have to move him at all? I don't.
Nope.
So, I'm just going to shoot.
He's going to try and kill my Ravage.
So, he has... You can use it an infinite number of times, too. So, yeah, totally going to use that.
All right, well, hand him over here. I'm going to show the way that shooting works real quick. So, you're shooting my Ravage. Give me your card. And you are using your Soul Splitter. Let's try to get this so you guys don't see your reflection here. So the Soul Splitter's weapon is Arbalest. It has a 20-inch range, a malfunction of 20. So if he rolls a 20, that's when he gets a malfunction. And a power of 8, and we'll get to that in a minute, and an assault of 8. So the way that your defense works, you add your defense, mine's 6, to the assault value of the weapon, the assault group, and then that's your target number. So it's going to be 14 or less he has to roll under to try and hit me. So 14 or less, he hits me. 16, he fails.
Boo. All right, and I was wrong. Actually, I was looking at the wrong one. He's actually got a rate of fire of 1, which means I can only use it once
per turn. Yeah, so you only use once per turn. So now you can relocate. Yeah, he's looking at his base. So you pick an assault group when you make an attack. He used number 2, and then you make the attack, and you've got your rate of fire, how many times you can do it. So with his bayonet, he can stab an infinite number of times, but with his arbalist, he can only use it once per turn. He's got to reload it afterwards. So there you go. I'll give that card back to you. You guys have a basic understanding of how attacks work.
So that's my first AP. My second AP is going to use his Obscuring Fog ability.
That's cool.
So he has a target number of 14.
Okay, that's a spell, basically. The spell cards will have a target number on them.
So I'm gonna get 14 or less? Yep. Critical.
So it's a super success. And what does that do now that he's got it in play?
I'm going to need the Blast 3-inch.
Okay.
Use that one, right?
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. And it basically goes under him and goes with him. And anything that draws line of sight through that, anybody that's in melee with that is at -4.
Awesome.
And then he's going to move his mighty 3.
It's radius, not circumference.
Oh, man.
Yeah, no, it's huge.
It's a lot bigger.
I know, we're used to 3-inch meaning like a 3-inch smoke template and something. No, he's got a huge, huge template that goes around with him.
And then he's got his 3-inch movement, so he actually, I'm just gonna
measure. He can get it on the sword then. In there.
And then get up to there. So anybody who gets into melee with that, as long as it's there, is going to be at -2.
Awesome. All right, well, this Haniel's going to go now and just get on up. Get on up. Now get on up. Again, he has 3 actions. Most of my army is not dudes. That's why I keep calling them she's. I'm just going to go hide behind this wall. All right, so we're going to activate some Soul Searchers.
So I'm actually going to reveal my dead drop objective. which requires me to move into contact with my actual
closest
to my deployment zone objective marker and interact with it, spending an AP, getting a bomb. Then I have to move that bomb towards your closest objective, which happens to be the one right beside it. So this worked out really, really well for me. So although I can't actually complete the objective till turn two, I can start it by getting
going
the bomb
grabbing
first.
Stuff. Yeah.
So I'm going to activate those guys and squad like them, so I can use both, because they're definitely within 4 inches.
Awesome.
And so I'm going to spend, it's going to take one AP for that guy to move over, and then his second AP to interact.
Okay.
Which should be actually leaving him with one, so he'll be able to move again.
Yep, now the terrain piece or the objectives are impassable, so you'll have to hop a wall, or you can just move back behind the wall even.
Which I think he's actually, for this turn, I think I'll hop a wall next turn, is he's just going to move back out of the way,
yep.
So that he can then spend 2 AP, move into base contact, and also get
the piece. So you got a backup. And we'll just mark those. We're going to mark those with some tokens just to say they have bombs.
All right, so both those guys now carry in bombs.
Now, interestingly, he's completely outactivated now because the slaves have all gone, and all 4 of his large Trigiri have gone as well, so the rest of my army gets to activate, which is good for me to remember for subsequent turns. My Banes are going to squad link and activate them because there's no downside to not doing so. Their movement of 3 with 3 actions, they can go 9 inches up. So 3, and then 6. I guess almost to here, but we're just not going to go quite so far. And then likewise, this Bane is going to move to here. John's going to go. So he's got 4 actions, but just like the Soul Surgeon, or Soul Surgeon, yeah. He's not, Soul Warden.
Warden.
He's not that fast. Only movement 2, he's wearing big heavy power armor, so he's just going to go up 8 to here. So with 4 actions on the medic, she's also only speed 2, so she's going to run up and hang with her friends. My weaponsmith's going to activate. He has a 16-inch range, which means I am in range of this Soul Searcher over here. But his gun is restricted to 2 shots by rate of fire. I also have a burst mode, but it's only got a 12-inch range. So I'm kind of debating what I could do here. I could hold my action, and that would let me fire once as he makes an activation. And maybe comes in the open, which means I can cover this right here. Or I can try and kill one of these guys and hopefully get the bomb not to be planted. So I think I'm just going to take 2 shots at this Soul Searcher and hope that I kill him. My assault value is 7. What's your defense?
On the Soul Searcher, defense is 6.
Okay, so 13 is my target number, but you are in cover. All right, so it's a minus 4, meaning I need a 9 or less with my shots here. First AP, 9 or less. That's crit. It's malfunction, but luckily the weaponsmith has an ability called Superior Maintenance 3. So 3 times per game I can ignore malfunctions because he's working on his own gun. So I'm just going to ignore that first one.
Come on,
send a second AP to try and hit you.
2. Oh, that hits.
Cranks you. So the damage on the rifle using the rifle shot is power 7.
So I have armor 18.
You got it.
So I'll need to roll in less than 11.
Now, with 1 AP left, he is just going to sit still. Alright, so it ends our round as everyone is now activated. We are going to put our cards, I guess, untapped, because we've kind of been tapping them to keep track of who's activated and who's not. And we're going to do our before the activation movement of all the slaves.
Yay, slaves.
Now, does his fog expire now?
It does, so at the end of the turn, I believe, is when it actually disappears.
Or maybe it's during the
preparation
the preparation phase, yeah.
So it'll be gone for this turn. So the slaves have to go.
Mm-hmm.
I really want to use the Shard Slave, but you're not going to start with them. So I'm going to move, activate the Shard Slaves here, well, one at a time, and just move them behind this wall for now. Because they have, it's going to take...
They can lay out minefields, they have some neat abilities.
Yeah, so I want them to be there for now. These guys, I'm going to run right past
you. Okay. And it's worth noting we're now on turn 2. We'll use this red d20 we won't pick up to mark what turn we're on. And there's 8 game rounds in a game. These guys are gonna go through. There's a door there too you can go through, obviously.
Oh yeah. I'll use the door. Go out through the kitchen.
Here comes these guys.
And I'm actually gonna hear some of these ones over here. Let's give you some fodder.
Yeah, it's hard to not think of them as being one squad, but they're not. They're just dudes. So they can always run around and be separate.
And then the slave taskmaster. So the slave taskmaster, I'm going to activate him. He's got 3 AP and a movement of 3, so. I don't want him to get too close yet, but I can hide him behind that wall.
That wall. There you go. You're safe. Now it's 2 initiative. 3.
Ah.
10. We got you. I'm actually going to force Jordan to go first, because at the end of this turn, not left really in range that I want to try and kill. I'm going to make him activate the Soul Warden.
The Soul Warden?
That's right.
Oh, man. I didn't see that one. So I can activate the Soul Warden. The spell I want to use is, sadly, an 8-inch range. So I need to get a little bit closer.
Which sure
is
do.
Dangerous. So the first thing.
This is why I'm activating
him. Why do I have to go? I have to.
You're just under 12.
Just under 12. So you're gonna have to spend.
Remember, this thing is impassable and blocks line of sight.
Yeah, so I'm gonna have to. Well, I can shoot at somebody else if I go this way.
Yep.
Which I think I might do. So I'm gonna go 4 inches. So that'll be 2 AP to move in there. And then I'm within 8 yet. Oh man.
Not quite.
I'm within 8 of the guy that I can't see.
That's right.
Yeah. So I have to use another one to move him over this way. It should give me 8 of him. Yeah. And then he's going to cast Ice Storm, which is a blast. So I have to hit.
Okay, so how big is the blast?
The 2-inch.
2-inch is the one you had before, so it's this one right here. Gotcha. And you're casting at the Bane or at the Haniel?
The Haniel, because it's the only guy I can see.
Awesome. Okay, so the Haniel. Oh, you can see the Bane too. You definitely see his base. He's just obscured. And I control the cover because I'm closer.
Am I within 8? All right, cool, yeah. I'm going to go for the Bane then.
Okay, I was going to say. They're both in heavy cover, I think. Let's just see. This doesn't have the keyword light or heavy cover, which means I don't get any benefit from it, so I'm just standing in the open as far as you're concerned.
So the assault value is 6, your defense value?
My defense value on a Bane is 6 as well.
6, so all right, so I need 12 or less.
Get him.
Yay! So you put the blast over him.
Kadoosh!
So
it's going to get the Field Medic, it's going to get the Haniel, it's going to get John and the Bane.
So it's a power 6.
Power 6, okay. The armor on the Bane is 18, so 12 or less, he's okay. He's good. The Haniel's armor is armor 16, so 10 or less, and he's good. He's good with the crit. The Field Medic is...
Die.
Please don't die.
Die.
She got 2 hit points, though, which is good. 14. Ooh. 14,
21.
So 8 or less. She's good.
Line, 20.
And then John's is 22.
So, okay.
So I need a 16 or less. And he's the one that's
going to fight. Yeah, critical. Takes double two.
Wound. Takes 2 wounds. You got 1 wound left. Stay there and it's rough terrain. But now John's got 2 wounds on him. He's only got 1 left. So that ends the Soul Searcher's activation. Now it's over to me. Okay, so my Haniel, now in rough terrain, is going to use his quick draw ability to spend 1 AP to aim and fire in the same turn. And he's going to do a armor-piercing shot against your Soul Warden. So 7. What's your defense on Soul Warden?
A mighty 8.
Ooh, jeez, okay. So, 15 or less. It's a single shot here. It's aimed. It's a 17 or less.
Yeah.
Crank him. 10 gets you. And it is damage, because it's the armor-piercing, 6 times 2.
All right, so I got to roll 2 dice, and I have armor 16, so I got to roll 100.
8 or less. No, sorry, 10 or less. 10 or less.
Okay, so he takes 1 wound.
And there you go. So you're now 1 AP. I've got 2 left. It's going to cost me an extra inch to get out of here, so 2 inches to get out. So with a movement of 3, that means I can move 2 inches away, because it'll be 1 to get away. And then another 1, 2 I can move. We're going to head over this way, like so.
There's a window.
There's a window. It's over to you.
All right.
Man, you might just kill John.
I was really hoping.
Who's going now?
So I'm going to activate the Soul Splitter.
Big surprise.
Yeah, with his okay. Bolt Thrower. I want to try and kill John.
Yeah, so big surprise. I need to see what John does.
Can I get to move him over a little bit?
Yep, just sure so
he's still up here.
And then he can aim.
Yeah, I am going to aim. That's my idea. Well. And then I will shoot my bow.
Your ballista.
My Arbalest.
I'm defense 4.
So the nice thing about Arbalest too is it actually gets to keep going if I do stuff.
It'll go through my Bane and then potentially go through my Ravage as well.
Which would be awesome.
I bet it would.
So with my aim, I have an assault value of 10.
Okay, plus 4 is 14.
14, come on, 14! No!
Yay, misses, and it's rare far 1, so John lives.
And that's his activation.
I'm gonna activate the Ravage. He's gonna incendiary grenade this guy. You know it's not, you know what ice doesn't like? Fire. So my Ravage has an 8-inch range to throw his grenade. He's gonna use the incendiary one. He's assault 6, but he's going to focus for his first action, which will give him plus 2 to make him 8. What's the defense on you?
Defense of the Soul Warden is ridiculous. It's an 8.
It's an 8. Okay. Oh, hang on. What did you roll to hit, John? I have a defense of 6 on John. I was lying to you. You got a 16. You totally hit me. Let's resolve that right now before I get to my activation, because I just realized I was looking at actions, which is 4, not defense. I was looking at the thing above it.
That's
so you just totally hit me. Yeah.
All right, so.
Excitement level increases.
Yeah, way more exciting.
Game enjoyment increasing exponentially.
All right, so if I hit you and you fail your armor save, then it keeps goes going. Through. So okay. The damage on it is, or power rather, is 8.
Okay, and I'm 22, so that means 14 or less, and it's 1 or 2.
Just 1.
Okay, 14 or less. I'm good. Right, back to your regular scheduled grenading. So my grenade, which is rate of fire 1, so I only have to do this once, is assault 8, and you said your defense is...
8.
16 or less to hit you with an incendiary grenade.
Ooh.
2.
I gotcha.
What's this, the power?
Well, the power is 6x2, but it's fire cauterized. So you can't heal it, and you get a fire counter if it goes off.
All right, so I'm armor 16. The damage was...
Your armor 16, minus 6, so 10 or less with 2 dice.
Come on!
Ah! So you take another wound.
I'm on fire.
And you're on fire. Now, fire
actually,
happens when
he's
you...
actually dead already, because he's
got 2?
2 wounds, yes.
Whoa! I am.
Exploded.
I get to reveal my objective. I got... Call to Glory, my 75-point guy killed an 80-point guy. So I get a victory point for that. So we're going to mark victory points with these big dice. So that puts me... I still have an AP left, so I'm actually going to use that to move him over... Yeah. Over... Yeah, like so. Like that.
Yep. All right, so I'm going to activate the only things I have left. So I'm actually going to not Soul Link them this turn. So I'm going to activate...
Squad Link them, yeah.
Squad Link them, yeah. Soul Link's a completely different rule. I'm going to move him... So it's a wall, so you can move over it.
By hopping it for 1 AP, yep.
Yeah, so...
Oh, sorry, no, it's it's just a wall.
So yeah, so I can just move over.
That's right.
So it's going to take me...
It's less than your height.
Going to take me 2 to get over to there with his bomb.
And 3 to activate one.
I believe they have a third. Yep, they do. So I'll activate my bomb. Thus...
And that scores you an AP.
Getting my dead drop, so you're going to get me 2 AP.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Now, does this guy hang on to his bomb now that the card's gone?
It won't matter,
I guess.
So I've already got it. So
but maybe you might draw that one again, is all I'm saying.
No, they're only once in the box.
Okay. All right, we're going to activate this Haniel. She's in range.
Ah.
She's going to aim, and then armor piercing shot you with her storm rifle. So armor piercing is assault 7. What's your defense?
Defense 6.
Defense 6. I had 13 or less, 15 or less, because I aimed. Hit you. Yeah. And it is damage 8x2.
Oh.
Sorry, no, I'm lying to you. 6x2.
Okay, so I need 12 or less then, because I've got armor 18. Another
damage.
Wound.
He is now wounded. Alright, and with my last AP, I'm gonna get not within murdering range of him. Like so. You, so.
So. I only have one guy left, so the souls are just gonna activate. And moving back really messed me up. So, let's move. I'm gonna try and back these guys up. I'm just gonna burn all 3 of my AP and move 9 over to there.
To activate Weaponsmith, he is going to aim with his rifle shot, and he's going to take a shot at... Oh, actually, hang on, let's just hang on a second. Maybe I can burst. He's going to do the regular shot, not the burst shot, because I think you're going to be hard enough to hit as is. So I'm assault group 2 here with my rifle shot, and I can use either or in this turn. I'll be 9 because I aimed for the first shot. What's your defense?
My defense is 6.
So 15 or less with the first one. Let's see if I get it.
Yeah.
Gotcha. It is the damage of, power 7.
7, all right, so I need an 11. Yep.
You get it. And the second shot's not aimed, so 13 or less. Nope.
Yay.
Now you are activated out, which means I'm going to continue activating models. It's time to get the Banes not where they are. We're just going to squad link them and just do them right now. Well, it doesn't even really matter because I can just go. Am I within 6? I am not. So I'm just going to get into melee, I think, with her.
If you connect, you get an attack.
I do. So that's a charge attack. She is assault 6. What's your defense?
Defense Soul Searcher is 6.
All right. She gets 2 attacks per activation with a double mace. So 12 or less. I hit you once.
Power?
Power is 4.
Armor 8.
Oh, wait. Hang on. See if I knock you down. 8 or less.
Oh, yeah.
It has an ability called Knock Prone. 8. You roll a dice before you do damage. And if I knock under that, nope. You're not knocked down.
So damage was 4?
4, yeah.
4, so I need a 14.
He's good. Good. Next Bane, he's gonna go, and he's gonna go 3 and then 3 again and charge this slave.
Yeah!
Oh, sorry, it cost me more than that to get out of there, doesn't it? So that's in the center here.
Oh, yeah, rough.
So rough, and I'm within
an inch and a half.
Inch and a half, so that's 3 inches to get just to the edge of the first one, so 3 inches to get me to there just to clear it. And that gives me 3 inches again. With my second AP, we'll move into contact with this slave.
Crunch.
Defense.
Huh. Terrible.
Defense bad.
Well, the defense 6. They're actually still pretty bad.
That's not bad. That's not great. It's not bad. So I need 12 or less. 2 attacks. Get you with 1.
1.
Damage 4.
Armor 10! Ah!
6. Gets it. Swing on him again. 12 or less. Hit you once.
That's 1. Come on. Another 6. Nah, it's 9.
Alright, so I crunch that guy in the face. On that first one, but I did. So I've already been messing this guy up because I haven't been doing his power generator each round, but we'll just say he's been powering his maul the whole time because that would have helped me with my saves. I didn't realize the power generator would actually help me with my armor saves, which might have saved me some hit points, but we'll just say that my maul's been getting powered this whole time, trying to make me more killy. So it's going to cost me an inch to get out. So for my first move, it's 2 inches. It's just going to put me on the side here. I've got 2 AP left.
So I'm going to move again 2 inches over to here. And then we're going to fire our Death Disc Launcher with 12-inch range into this fella.
No.
And I guess we'll aim first before we do it. So the Death Disc Launcher has a 12-inch range. Assault 9 now. What's your defense? 6.
I'm defense 6.
So 15. I need 15 or less, and I get a single shot. Ah. Got it. So it's damage 6 times 2.
No.
Armor 18, so I need 12s.
Got last AP with John, so now we're going to do the field medic. She's just going to continue, because this is going to go away next turn. She's just going to crawl forward and continue hanging out behind here. She can't actually heal this guy back to life, I don't think. She can just bring guys. She can just bring this guy who are almost dead that come back. So that was my first move. I guess I'll just do it again to move over to John. And then we're just going to remove both his damage. So she can only remove one of his, because he can only be affected by just a flesh wound once again. Thinking about it, it probably would have taken all my AP just to get over there and do it. So we are now activated out. That's going to put us on to turn 3.
With
lingering activation, lingering stuff now taking place. We're going to remove that template. That goes away. Bloody people are still bloody. And we will now activate the slaves.
Yeah.
So we can both discard and draw objectives before that happens. Actually, I'm going to get rid of counterattack because it sucks. And then I'm going to get 2 more. Alright, and with that, we can now start the slave movement.
Preparation phase! So, I'm gonna do these guys first because they're easy. Do that, and that. And then these guys are just going to run through the hills.
What?!
As fast as possible.
Run to the hills!
Exactly what went through my head.
Is that the exact song that's going through your head right now? Run for your lives! My bad Iron Maiden.
Even bad Iron Maiden's good Iron Maiden.
It's true. Okay. So now, walls, these are medium height walls, which means a medium or bigger guy can just walk over them freely. The slaves are small size, which means they have to spend an AP to jumpable them, so there's a jumpable trip or trait. They start in base contact with it, they can be moved to the other side still in base contact, which basically means they have to climb over it. His first move, now he's going to move over and stab.
Second move is to move and stab.
Poor Haniel. Okay, so my Haniel is defense 4.
Spear slaves have a mighty assault value of 2.
Ooh, so 6 or less?
6!
Ah! Alright, get Baney time.
These ones, yep, they're gonna move. Both of them are gonna go in there and do some sticking.
Get Baney with it. Alright, yeah. Well, I think you did one at a time, right?
Oh, so yep, sorry. Right.
So that's where he is.
Thinking of their units.
It's hard not to visualize them as units. So again, you get 6 or less for your first attack.
So the first one, 6. Nope.
Second
and
one?
Second AP. Nope. Rewind.
And again.
And again.
This is why 6. You get lots of slaves. Not
no.
So good.
6. Yay.
Oh, you hit me. All right, what's your damage?
3.
Armor. This is not a hand, it's a Bane.
It's a Bane, yeah.
Bane is armor 18. So 15 or less. That makes sense why you have 1,000,000,000 of these things.
Just a billion.
They're not so good at doing things. So. All right, so these guys who are in base contact are going to jump.
Yeah, so they're going to just jump the wall. Over to there. And then they're, oh, I gotta do it one at a time. And yep. That guy's gonna use his shard field rule.
Okay.
To put down, use 2 this turn. A shard field and base contact just underneath that guy.
All right, it's like a little landmine, so he's just gonna scatter a shard field basically underneath me.
Yep, and really hope that you roll badly.
Okay.
And then this
does it detonate immediately?
It does not. At the beginning of your activation with that model.
If I'm in it,
you have to test to see if it's, it blows up.
Okay.
And then this guy's gonna do it. And he's actually going to, you know what?
He drop one as well?
Yeah, he'll drop one too.
Might as well drop one as defensive, basically. Yeah. Can they overlap?
I don't know, so I'm just not going to overlap. Okay. Last two, rather. He's going to go 3, and then 2, and he's going to move 5, just in the way.
He has 2 AP?
Yep. All the slaves do.
So you move, that's right. So you move 5, though, that's right.
Yeah, they move 5. So that's right. 4 and 1, and he's going to come up behind.
I'm surprised you didn't drop a shard field there. Okay.
It costs an AP to do it.
No, I know, but you were here and you could put one in front of him.
But you have to start your activation in it for it to blow up.
Okay.
So unless there's a model already
start
on it.
Start an activation or start an action?
Start an activation, I believe.
Got it, okay. Taskmaster.
So Taskmaster, yep. He's going to move 2 inches. Sorry, 3 inches. And then another one. I got to double check the rules for reach, though.
We should check, too, what happens when someone dies nearby, because the dude died over here, these guys might have had to gain panic counters. All right, so with reach, he can actually fight through that line there.
With his whip.
Take some strikes at my banes with his whip.
So he has an assault value of 5.
Defense 6, so 11.
11! Yeah! Whip
cranks me. Damage?
So this is actually a 3x2, and if you...
Whoa!
It has a special rule, whiplash, so if you fail your armor save, you're actually going to gain a counter. Okay. Although I think you're dead.
I just die. Yeah. I would go to dying because my medic's in range. So 3x2. I'm armor 18 though. So 6.
Yep. 16. It's power 3x2, so it's 2 dice.
Power 3x2, it's 2 dice. Okay. So it's 13. No, 15 or less twice. 19. I take a dying counter. Bleeding out, man. I'm so cold. So
you could hit me again and actually kill me. We had to move 2 there.
So now we're actually going to initiative. Yeah, I feel like a whole turn happened while other things were happening. So let's roll off to see who goes first.
Oh, you're a 1.
I rolled a 1. Yeah. Interference. I can pick who goes first. I think I'm actually going to take the Alpha Strike here because I kind of need to.
Blow up the shard. Blow up the shard.
No, I'm just going to shoot into melee.
All right, so this Haniel's going to activate. She's going to move. 3, and then she's gonna use quick draw to aim and fire as her last AP. The melee penalty that I've got here from me being in melee with your soul searcher.
Yep.
I am shoot 7.
I am defense 6.
13. Right, so I have 13 or less with my handle here. Come on and get him. Get him.
That's it.
It is arm piercing, which is 8. Sorry, 6 times 2.
Ooh, 6 times 2 is 8 12s. No, critical,
double wounds.
We already only had 1 left.
So that puts him down, and that's going to give me killing blow. No. The enemy model that's missing 1 or more AP is killed. It's me 2. All right, so that's him activated. It's over to you.
Alrighty. Huh. Well, I think I'm going to activate my guy with the giant bow.
Giant bow?
Giant bow. So he's going
to... Murder man?
Yeah, he's going to move over. He just keeps readjusting, so he keeps shooting.
Because I keep ducking behind boxes. Yeah.
No boxes. So he's going to use his second AP to aim, and then his last one to actually shoot.
Okay.
So
defense, I'm going to not lie this time. Defense is 6 on John.
6, okay. So I'm going to have an assault of 10, so I'm going to need a 16.
Okay.
Yay!
Got it. Armor 22.
Power 8.
Ooh, so I need a 14 or less.
Yeah. Fail it!
Good. Also, boom. Forgot to say what I was powering again this turn. I'll keep powering my maul. We're going to activate Ye Olde Weaponsmith over here, and he's going to move like so. And he's going to aim, and he's going to use his burst fire within 12.
Boom.
I actually can't aim here. Yeah, I know. I just realized my burst actually has to all target the same model. I'm actually better off to just do individual shots against you. Not even to aim, just to do 2 individual shots. Because we're in part 2. So the first individual shot against this guy. Actually against this guy because he's closest to my deployment zone.
Defense 6.
Assault 7. Not aimed. So just needing a 13. 15 misses. Second shot. Not aimed. Misses.
Good job.
All right. Over to you.
I only have 1 model to activate. So.
That's true.
I can't get through there because he doesn't have reach. He's only got 0. I don't think I can get through those bases.
Searcher has reach. Do you have to charge? You just walk to here.
Searchers don't have reach. They have range 0.
Oh.
Naginatas, although big, are not amazing. Yeah, I don't think I can make it through that, and the objectives are impassable.
That's true.
So, yeah, let's just spend 3
get AP death
going.
Get shot with death disc.
Run away.
Plan? Okay, sounds good. All right, so dying counters are technically not activated, so I think I can actually go heal this guy, which I'm going to go try and do. Or I could do my Ravage, or I could do John, or I could blow up my shard dude.
Boom! He's gonna die.
He's gonna pig stick you.
No!
So my handle's gonna activate. His pig sticker is his knife, and he has an assault on his pig sticker of 6. So his first action is gonna stab you. What's your defense?
Defense 6. Well. Yep.
12 or less. Getcha.
No!
It's damage 4, or power 4, sorry.
6! No.
Dead. Turns around, stabs him in the face. Next AP, we are going to move back so we can see through this window, like so. And then last AP, we are going to... Actually, no, sorry. We're going to go this way over here. And then last AP, we're going to fire flechettes. That's a kajunk like this, not going to hit anybody else, just the slave taskmaster. And the flechettes are... Actually, there's no reason to use the flechettes. I could just use the armor piercing instead.
Pew, pew.
Yeah, I'm going to use the armor piercing instead. I'm not going to hit more than one guy.
You might actually be engaged.
Oh, it's, well, I'm not base to base. Do you fight over a wall?
3-inch reach.
Oh, I am engaged. Never mind. I guess I'm going to do nothing. Locking that window is a stupid idea because now I'm engaged and I can't even fight back because I'm not base to base. So whips come to the window. Well, I guess I'll just keep activating. Good job, Ash. Well played. Way to make it happen. So Ravage is going to aim and then he's going to throw a blast grenade into this fell right here.
Ooh.
With an 8. So I'm assault 8 right now, so 14 or less. I get it. And it's a 2-inch blast, so it's going to hit all these three guys.
Yep.
Knock prone 10, though, so 10 or less on him. He's not knock prone. Knock prone 10. He is knock prone, and this guy knock prone. if they live. Nope. So this guy we knock down if they live.
Yep.
And the damage on it is 4 times 2.
Ooh. Okay. So shard slaves are armor 10, and you roll 6s or less. I'll do the guy who's knocked down prone first. He is dead twice. Guy closest to John dead. Is dead, and the guy standing over there. Oh, he's super dead 3 times.
And with my last AP, I am going to move 3 inches later, actually over here after these fellas. You're still activated out, so I guess time to get the. And you have a 3-inch reach, so I can't melee, but I can go heal. So I'm actually going to move 2, and then 2 again into base to base with the medic. And then she's gonna spend an AP to heal.
So this guy wakes up. Aged?
I doesn't say I can't, just says I can be in base base. Yep, base kind of a looming model. So that means he stands up, but he can't be healed again. And you know, I'm actually gonna mark that. I'm just gonna put green counters on the guys who've been healed, because I don't want to accidentally do it again. So that means he's been healed an AP and he's been or healed a wound. And the Bane's gonna activate now, because it doesn't say anywhere that a dying model can't activate this turn, I don't think. So, well, no, because I don't have the dying counter anymore, so I'm no longer prone.
But you would be, you, to change the prone state is you have to spend an AP, right?
I guess. It just says the thing makes me prone. I guess I would still be prone when I get healed. Oh, it's the counter maybe. I don't know. We'll say I do. So I'm going to get up for 1 AP then with this guy. I'm going to swing on that slave. 12 or less on the first spear slave. There's 1 hit, and it is a double mace, which means it is damage 4.
Damage power 4, sorry. Armor 10, so 6. Nope.
And then we're going to swing on this fella, 12 or less. Gets twice.
Double less.
Nah. Explodes. And my AP to stand up means that I'm not going anywhere else. All right. Explosivo, activate. This shard thing goes off. Roll D10. Or I roll D10. On a 10 or less, I'm fine, you said?
Yep.
10.
Ah, boo.
So I will charge like so. So I'm no longer in the exploding
good
field.
Call.
And then make murder on you.
Murder.
Second one, in 12 or less against hitch twice.
Yep. Oh no.
Oh, lived. Last AP, do it again. Hitch once.
Come on. 6 or less. Live. Ah.
It was a real bridge too far. All right, time to move Johnny. Johnny's gonna move 2 over this way. Like, yeah. And he's gonna start lighting up with his death disc. So he's gonna death disc. I think he's in range. All right, so we are going to take John's shot into this fella right here. All right, so it's a 9 or less into this guy. Sorry, not 9 or less. It's 9 plus your. It's 15 or less, but I hit you with a 4. And then it is damage 6 times 2.
Oh, man. 4s! No.
Nope. So he gets exploded. And that was 1 to move, 1 to aim, 1 to fire. I have 1 left. I'm going to move 2 more. Over this way. Get these guys out of my zone. Get these slaves out of my zone! So, end around. You've got 1 or more friendly models in my deployment zone.
Yep, so okay. I got infiltrate, so that's 1. And then I also have forward location is, oh wait, I think I might. I don't know if I have forward location. I gotta check. Technically? Is that on your side? That's 24.
That's 24, so this side's my side. So yeah. What do you need for forward location?
I sort of need base contact with an objective marker on
it's more side. It's more on my side, so right. I'd say yes. So at the end of this round, I've shielded 260 now, and that means I've scored 2 primary objective VP, because I've killed 200. Draw 1 new objective. Alright, so now it's during the, before the activation phase, and you get to move your slaves. I realize that all of his shard slaves had infiltrate, which would have probably made them further up the table by far this game.
So I'm gonna activate the slave taskmaster first.
So he's engaging, technically, my models, but he's not himself engaged, so he could move freely, so as far as we can tell, and then over there.
And then I'm gonna make my attack against, her, actually.
No, not the field medic! Okay, she is defense, probably not defense 5, so you get 10 or less, and you get 1 here. That's a 4.
Four.
So crank me. She is armor bad.
And it's power 3 and you
armor
have 2 rolls.
14, so 11 or less twice.
Yeah.
She makes 1, she's got 2 wounds though. So she's got 1 left.
My next AP is going to be attack again.
Okay. Defense of 5. So 10 or less.
Nope. And the third one. Yep.
That's going to get me. And then it's 2 again at. You said it's damage 2?
Power 2. 3 times 2.
Power 3 times 2. So I need 11 or less twice. Good! Comes the spear, you guys.
Pile up!
You've achieved your objective! Go murder things! Now they have reach.
Yep, they have reach.
So they can go and engage this guy, and he can't do anything except for climb down after them.
I just don't want you to shoot, I'm going to be honest.
That's fair. That's yeah. I honestly, looking at the slaves, they're for jamming tactics, and then exactly what you did, which is run to my deployment zone.
So they're just spending all of their AP...
to run around.
To run around and get as close as possible.
Go for initiative. 11.
Yeah!
Going first.
Uh-oh.
Well, you make me go first, too.
Yeah. I'm going to make you activate the Bane.
Really? Okay. Well, he's going to swing on your Taskmaster. What's his defense?
My Taskmaster is defense 6.
I am assault 6, so I need a 12 or less. Hits you.
Yep.
And it is... Oh, sorry, I get 2, actually. I get only 1, though. That hits. Power 4.
Armor 6.
So, your armor 6?
No, wait. Armor 12. I'm
okay. I was going to say 6. Yeah, so armor 6, 12, 8 or 12, less. So
8 or less.
It's only 1.
Nope.
Just wrote 1, yeah. No, you're still dead.
Takes a wound, sorry.
Takes a wound, he's got 2?
Yeah.
All right, I'll hit you again. It's 2 attacks. The 6 will hit.
Dead. I'm going to reveal my strategy.
Okay.
Or my...
Well, I gain a head token.
And you gain a revenge token, too.
Oh! If so someone's going to try and kill me?
Yep. Revenge tokens cannot be removed, and if I kill you, I get an objective.
Man, all right, well, that's not good.
And now it's my activation. So I'm going to activate him.
Okay.
So Soul Searchers have a move of 3, so it's going to take me 2 to get there.
It's a trap!
It was a trap.
Amazing.
And then make his attack.
Okay.
So he gets 2 attacks. I have assault value 8.
Okay, and defense of 6 and a main.
6, so...
14 or less.
2 hits. Power 6.
18, so 12 or less twice. Get 1, get the other. Go again.
Last AP.
1 hit.
1 hit. 8, then 6, right?
Yeah, and armor 18, so 12 or less. I'm good. He lives. I'm going to take the field medic, and she's going to run and hide.
Boo.
She has 4.
How did you know what my next activation was?
Not stupid. We're going to run and hide behind this thing right here. And be like, no way, Jose! You wanna come get me to get off that thing? She can't heal herself, though. Over to you, sir.
Okay. So, I only have him to activate. So, it'll be the Soul Splitter. He's going to move just over to the edge here. And then he's going to shoot into melee. So he'll get +2.
Okay. +2, -2, because he aimed. Yep. So straight hit, defense 6.
Yep. With assault 8, so 14. Yep.
You got some. All right, damage.
All right, come on.
18, come on. 10 or less. Good.
Ah! Cyberblast has been useless.
Super Bane. All right, we're going to activate Haniel, because he's not engaged now, because Whip Guy's dead. And Haniel is going to quick draw aim for 1 AP and shoot your Soul Splitter. Your Soul Splitter.
Yep.
He's range 8. He's going to use Armor Piercing. Range 8, just double check my range. Oh, yeah, I got lots of range.
Yep.
Defense?
6.
Okay, so I am 9 with my Storm Rifle right now, because I aimed. I need 15 or less. Get you with 7.
Yep.
That's -2, 6.
Okay, so I need 10 or less.
3 and 13, so it's a damage. And then I guess I've got some AP left, because that was only 1. So I can move 2, 3.
Does it have rate of fire more than 1?
It is, no, it's only rate of fire 1.
Ah.
So I can actually go 3 and 3. So I'm going to go 3, and 3 again at this door over here. Be like, what's up, y'all? All right, John's gonna activate, and he's gonna try and take a shot at your Soul Splitter again. So he's gonna spend 1 AP to aim, and then shoot you up there on the hill. I am assault 7, so 9, so 15 or less again.
Yep.
Get you with a 5, 6 times 2 again for death discs. That's rated fire 1.
10. No.
Oh, double dead. John. Deleted. Face. He's got 2 AP left. So I'm thinking we want to go murder some dudes. Because that's how we do. And we're going to go 1, 2, I think it's 4.
Yeah!
I want to go.
Come closer to the slaves. Do it.
You're not going to kill me with the slaves, though. That's the thing. So I'm just going to go.
Oh, now I really want to kill you with the slaves.
I hope you do. I'm just going to go over here and jam on. You're activated out, which means I can activate my Ravage. He's going to charge. Right like that. And try and punk somebody. So his double discs, or his double clubs, or whatever. They are assault 6.
Defense 6.
2 attacks, though, so 12 or less. Hit twice. Damage 4.
Armor 10.
Power 4 6. Okay, now he gets a head token. He's got a head token. That was his first one.
So he's not going to quite make it to the objective this turn, so he's going to go three and then three again, so he's on the other side of her, but he's in base to base.
I wonder which one you have.
Same one I had before. Yeah. Activate Bandy Bane, and she's going to move. She's going to go nine, so three and then three and then three again, just trucking it over here. She's going to activate. She's going to go nine as well, so I'm just going to go eight and then one more. So I'm engaged, which means I actually can't move. So I have to actually break off for 2 AP to even just get to attack you, because I can't move to even jump down the wall, which is weird, but I can't. So I'm going to try and break off for 2 AP, which is free, I can. And I can't engage anybody else at the end of the movement. You're movement two, so I'm going to move over to here. And then I'm just going to shoot you with my burst shot. We fucked that up a little bit, actually. We assumed that because a model with reach could attack, make its charge attack 2 inches away, and it would benefit from ganging up, that it was also engaging me. It's not, which is interesting. So I can actually sit here and shoot you if I want, and not be engaged. And vice versa, the hand heal over here, which was in range of your Taskmaster, would have been able to shoot as well.
Yeah, and I would have been able to make my attacks too.
That's right, exactly. So that's interesting. Again, a futz up, but we caught it. We've also not been getting the range penalties right. For every 4 full inches between me and the target, you're at minus one, minus two. Yeah, minus one to hit.
I haven't done any range anyways.
Yeah. Well, no, all your magic would have been as well.
Any magic with the range,
magic spell stuff, all my shots would have been at minus a bunch. So at 16 inches away, I'd be at a maximum of minus four.
Yeah.
At max range. And then 20-inch range guy would have been at...
Maximum five,
yeah. Minus five. So just interesting. We've not gotten that right, but hopefully our next game...
Game two.
We'll take it to account. That's why we do more than one game. All right, so I'm just going to burst fire. So three shots from... where is he? Mr. Weaponsmith. And he is assault five. Can't be aimed because it's burst.
And six. 11.
And six. 11's less. There's one. It is damage six. So power six.
Four.
No. Nope. So he's deleted. His next AP, he's just going to climb down. And then move another three over here. That is turn. So maintenance phase, you can reveal anything?
Nope, but I'm going to discard.
Okay, I'm also going to discard. Oh, no, I'm not. I'm going to keep them all. So now I'm at 330 points killed, which will put me up another VP at the end of the round. All right, so here we go.
Slaves. They will kill John.
They're going to kill John?
They're going to kill John.
All right, here we go, John.
So I'm going to do this guy first, and he's going to move five. Around to get back here.
Yep, because he doesn't have to engage me in a straight line.
And then make his one attack.
Okay, I'm defense of, I believe I said four, John? Yeah, no, six.
Six, so I need a mighty eight.
Nope.
The next guy. This is ganging up, though.
Oh, that was your charge attack. You get another one.
Oh, yeah.
Two APs.
Two actually. Two things. No, hits. That hits.
Damage?
Three.
Three, so I need 19 or less.
19 or less. Okay. I will make you roll 20s.
That's right. Just kill me outright.
Then the second guy. Now I do this.
Surround John. Yep. Force him to cleave his way through the Phoebes.
Yep, that's the idea.
Okay.
And then his first one, which gets plus one.
Now it's getting up. Plus one, actually.
So, nope, I needed a seven.
You need a seven? Are you sure? Because I'm defense six.
Six, so I needed... I did.
Nine, yeah, so you got me.
Yep.
And now it's down damage power one four. Better, so 18 or less. Good.
Yeah.
Next, you hit me again. No, there's two attacks.
Oh, yeah.
Hit me again.
That's bad.
It's okay.
Nope. Misses. Next guy.
So now it's 10 or less, and 17 or less if I have to make my saves. So first attack, 10 or less, just right here.
Nope.
Second one, 10 or less. Yes. Yep. 17 or less. Good. Third one.
He might be...
5 inches? You got lots of range. Yeah. And remember, he's at 2-inch reach, too, right? So.
Yeah. Well, it's more getting the gang up. He's got to be base contact for the gang up.
No, you don't contribute it, but you do get it. I get what you're saying. Yeah. So 10, it's 11 or less now, I think.
So, yeah. First one misses.
Because it's, your assault value 2?
Yep.
So 8 plus 4? Because you contribute it.
So that's
no,
six.
Plus 3 for the additional bonus. So it's 11 or less. Yeah, yeah. So that's this next one.
Second one, 11 or less. Yep.
Gets it. All right. So now it's damage of...
Power 6.
6. So 16.
Yeah.
Oh, take damage! Uh-oh.
And the last guy.
Gonna kill John. The slaves.
He's totally got the reach. So he's gonna run in. So he gets the benefits. So he's gonna get plus four. So he has six plus your defense.
Six? Six 12. So 12.
No. Come on!
Get him!
Do it! Oh. No hits!
Uh-oh. Damage.
Power seven.
Power seven. So I need a 15 or less. Just gonna make John angry.
So angry.
Making John angry.
So angry. Okay,
the same phase. I'm gonna power up my armor this time, so hopefully I don't get killed. It's initiative roll.
Yeah.
I'm going first. All right, Bane.
I think it's time for you to bane this guy. Bane him good.
You can do it.
So I'm going to start striking the Soul Searcher. What's his defense? Six?
Six.
Maybe 12 or less. Two hits. It's power, or yeah, it's power of four.
14. I'm good.
Uh-oh. Second attack. 12 or less.
Double miss.
Third attack. Double hit.
Uh-oh. 14.
Dead. Did I get one on you already?
No.
No, I didn't.
On that one. Oh, the other guy got a wound.
All right, so that's just a wound, and now you get to go. Stupid Bane.
Naginata.
You have one job.
Defense on the Bane.
Six.
Six, so I need 14.
One hit.
One hit. Power six.
Power six, so I need a 12 or less. Dead.
Yay!
And he can't. Actually, sorry, he's dying, but he's already been healed once, so he can't be healed
dead,
again.
Dead, dead. So I'm going to...
Well, technically he's still on the board.
So I reveal a counterattack, which is a friendly model kills an enemy model that was within 2 inches at the start.
I'm not dead, I'm dying.
You're dying?
Yeah, you have to actually hit me again, because even though I can't be healed again, I just go back to the dying state.
More attacks!
I know.
So you're prone, so you're plus two
plus
defense.
Plus two, that's right.
So that
defense eight now.
16.
Cranking twice. I'm armor bad. 18, 12. Dead. Not
there you go. Now I reveal counterattack. Counterattack. And revenge.
And revenge. So counterattack and revenge, you get two more. So you're at six now for your BPs. So we're going to activate here. I'm going to interact with this objective to make a grisly reminder and put the head of that slave on a spike. And it's giving me a BP, so I'm at six as well.
It's so grisly.
He actually, I just realized I messed something up. He couldn't take a trophy because he took one first. I can only have one guy with a trophy at any one time. And when he's killed, I discard this objective.
Oh.
I have to reveal it as soon as I take the trophy. That was interesting. We futzed that up too. So Ravage is just going to activate then because he doesn't actually have any markers so on him.
Just kill me
and
instead.
I should actually technically have an extra objective card right now.
I actually would have discarded it last turn.
Okay, so now he's actually going to activate and pull a supply counter off this. Friendly model may spend 1 AP. The supply counter is completed when friendly models have a total of 4 more supply counters at the end of the round. So with his 2 AP left, he's going to move like so.
Pew pew.
And he's gonna chuck an incendiary grenade at you. Assault 6 against defense 6, you have 12 or less. Cranky with a 1, critical, double damage. He just gets murdered.
Kablunk.
Alright, activate her. She's gonna pull an objective marker off this thing. Activate her. She's gonna walk over here and pull a supply counter off this thing. Activate the Haniel. He's gonna move to here. I only move 3. No. And I'm gonna move to here. And I'm gonna pull a. No, actually, I'm going to fire my flechettes. Targeting this guy who's not engaged, but then I'll make rolls against these other two as well, because it's centered. So him, he is defense...
6.
I am assault 7, so and I can quick draw, actually, to fire it. All right, so I get the aim bonus only against him, which makes me a 9. I need a... You're 6.
15.
So 15 or less. So he gets hit, and it is damage 2 times 2. Power 2 times 2.
So armor...
10?
I'm losing 10. 8! Oh!
Lives. And then the next one, he needs 7, and your defense 6, 13, minus 2 because you're in melee, is 11. Misses. Next one. Hits.
Yep.
And it's 2 times 2 again.
There he goes.
Dead. Alright, so this guy's gonna walk, and then he's gonna walk again. And he's gonna walk one more time and be in base to base. This guy is just gonna run. She's gonna run. 8. And then 1. John, the activate.
Oh, right.
I gotta
get punched.
I got four attacks here. We're gonna maul ya. I'm assault 10. Defense
6.
6? Alright, 16 or 20. Less. Take a damage 8, or power 8.
Power 8?
Yeah.
So.
1 or 2?
Yep.
Squished.
Yeah.
This is why I didn't need to power the axe. Again on this guy. Hits. Dead. Last one. Hits. Dead.
Oh,
no, wait. You're an 8 or a 6? I actually missed.
Six.
I think I missed that one with the 17 because I'm only a 10. I missed that one. Last one actually.
The one that
made
I
your save.
The one I saved.
Yeah,
of course.
I hit him though. So final attack with my last AP.
Yeah.
16 hits you. Again, 1 or 2. No. Right, so I'm gonna gain infiltrate objective. So I go up to 6 now. And I think I've gotten over 400 points now. So I go to 7. All the marbles right now.
All the marbles.
Get them.
All right. So first
slaves
AP.
Go.
What do I got? I got.
I like how your slaves alpha strike.
Yep. So, assault 2, defense. Your defense?
My defense is 6.
6, so I need 8.
Oh, nine.
Come on!
One.
No!
No dice. Initiative doesn't matter because I just kind of automatically go. We'll activate the weaponsmith. He's gonna grab a supply token.
Oh, he's rubbing it in. That's don't it. Just kill my last mob.
Grab a supply token, and then we'll activate John, and he's gonna charge you. Hit on a 16 or less. Whoops, 16 or less. Hit you. One or two. That's an additional. Now I've gotten to 500, so I should get one more DP, and I'll go to 7, 8. For supplies, I go to 9. So if this was a tournament, it would be 9, 6 at the end of the game. All right, so there we go. At the end of the game, our first game of Dark Age, we went for a 9-6 Forsaken victory over the Dargiri. We both learned a lot about our armies.
Yeah, infiltrating is good if you remember to use it. That's an important part, I think.
Well, I think infiltrating and seeding all these things with the shards would have been a big deal.
Because the shards don't go away. You can range attack them, but they don't disappear, so if you start your activation there, there's a chance.
You can make it a hazard to go all the way around it. I think splitting up your spear slaves more, too, just to threaten all those things would have been a big deal. Because they're not great, but a whole bunch of them, and they get the alpha every single turn because they always go before the initiative roll.
I could have killed John.
They're almost they're almost like sentries. And you had how many of them?
9.
Yeah. I think in this mission especially, having them jam up all the objectives and just be like sentries while your guys in back basically are picking and choosing targets would have been a big deal.
Yeah.
So we learned a whole bunch. We obviously got some stuff wrong. We got our range attack slightly wrong because we futzed up the minuses for range penalties. And we just kind of learned as we go. We'll be back with more Dark Age. I hope you enjoy it. Check it out. All the links to Dark Age on the Kumani or Not web page will be in the description for this video. We recommend you go check it out. If you're looking for a low model count game, you can easily play 500 points with like any of the starters.
Yeah, like a starter, and the game is so easy and simple. Like we kept trying to overcomplicate it.
I know, we kept thinking rules were there from other games that we play, but they're not.
It's super simple.
It's super duper simple. Once you pick up the basic mechanic of assault plus defense equals your target, like once you figure out how to make the target numbers, and you've got a basic idea of like how range attacks and melee attacks work, it's way easier and fast. Yeah, and our last couple turns went way quicker than our first couple turns as we're figuring stuff out. So we'll do another game, another couple games actually, hopefully, and you'll be able to check it out some more. But yeah, give it a check out, click the link below and check it out right now. We'll see you for more Dark Age, more Out of the Basement stuff on lesser known and lesser played indie games. Until then, have fun.